During heavy storm, you have seen that the shade of any structure which are not designed for wind load are simply blown away. As you can see here, both the shade and the supporting truss are blown away and collapsing respectively by this strong wind. But how is this happening? Hi, I am Tonmoy. Welcome to my channel. If you are a civil engineer and new to this channel, please subscribe to get videos on analysis, design and construction. To understand the action of wind load, we need to recap our 12th standard physics. Recall the Bernoulli's principle. It says, energy per unit volume at any point is constant. Here, P denotes the static pressure of air. That means, when air have no movement, this pressure is equal in each direction. This is kinetic pressure. That means, thrust which is produced when air is moving. And this is potential pressure. As density of air is very low, we will neglect this in our discussion. So, Bernoulli's principle says that at any point, the summation of static pressure and kinetic pressure is constant. If any one increases, other one decreases. Let's say there is no movement of air around this house. So, what is the condition of pressure? As both inside and outside, there is no movement of air, static pressure or P is same and they balance each other. Now, let's see what happens when wind blows. At inside of the house, the air remains standstill, so no change in static pressure and it continues to exert pressure in each direction as it was exerting before. But at the outside of the house, due to motion of air, kinetic pressure has developed. Now, Bernoulli is saying total pressure is constant. That means the change in kinetic pressure is compensated by static pressure. As kinetic pressure has increased, static pressure has decreased. If wind speed increase more, kinetic pressure will increase more and static pressure will decrease more to maintain total pressure energy as constant. Now, you can see that force on inside of the shed due to static pressure is much more than the force on outside of the shed due to static pressure of air. Naturally, the resultant force is acting from inside to outside. So, during strong wind or cyclone, if seat is not connected properly, it is simply blown away by the force as shown here. If the connection is okay, then the force is transferred to the truss through purlin. If the truss or raptor beam is not designed properly, they will collapse. Now, let's check how does wind load act on the structure in real life. Here, initially all the joint fail. That's why seat have been blown away. Now, the joint seems to be okay and they are transferring the load to the truss through purlin. And as the truss is not designed properly, you can see the result. That's all. If you want more videos like this, you can see the suggested one and please don't forget to subscribe if you have not done it.